Hello and welcome. We are so glad to have you here. If you're with us on Facebook or YouTube, go ahead and subscribe to get notifications when we have new videos. If you're with us on Zoom, drop a hi in the chat. We'd love to say hello back. And if you're with us in person, hello everyone in the sanctuary. If this is your first time here, go ahead and sign the guest book either in the lobby or at oakcliffuu.org/guest. Today's sermon is 10 years of TXUUJM, the spiritual practice of showing up, with Reverend Aaron J. Walter. All right, announcements are so fun today because we have so much fun stuff and it's happening today. So listen, get ready to have an amazing day. Jazz Jam returns to our church today from 2 to 4. That's so much fun. Bring your instruments if you've got them, or just come to enjoy the jamming. And you can find out more about Jazz Jam, which is the second Sunday of every month, at labyrinthwalkcoffeehouse.com. And if that's not enough for you, if you haven't gotten your fill of fun, musical-oriented events out of your system after that, and who could? Tonight we have In the Beats We Trust Project holding an Interdependence Day event at our church. And this sounds so amazing. Listen up. This is a co-creative experience where energies flow between music, dance, and whatever is in your heart. It is a recreation of an ancient ritual of coming together and connecting through music, dance, and food, but in a modern, eclectic, Dallas-flavored way. How is that for a description? That is really great. You can find all the details on our website, on Facebook, on the e-blast, anywhere. That is 5 to 10 tonight. Also excited. Seriously, I love all these announcements this week. Sarah Latchton is holding meditations throughout the week. Oh my gosh, I love meditations throughout the week. Sunrise and sunset meditations, lucid dreaming, astral travel, drumming, walking, singing, laughing, breathing, and many, many more. You can check out the schedule at our website at oakcliffuu.org. I'm seriously excited about those. Remember when we used to have all those wonderful meditations on campus? Okay, so check out this week's e-blast for everything else going on, because there's so much, right? A message from the president's desk, Workday Wednesdays, sending postcards to politicians, that's a thing on there. Rita's Who's Who list, it's about that time. So if you're on a committee, check your email. And of course, Widening the Circle of Concern updates. They've posted a very interesting article as well on what to do when you've committed a microaggression. So all that stuff. It is Sunday and we don't leave you hanging after the service. There's so much to do, especially today, right? Tons of stuff to do all day long. So right after the service, we have a talk back at 11:15. That's where we talk about the sermon and related topics. Always get something, whether you come to talk or simply listen. We also have adult religious exploration at 11:30 with Sarah, and that's also always amazing. And that's it. We have no member anniversaries this week, so I will let you get on with your fantastic, amazing day. I hope that all of you out there have a very happy Sunday.
Good morning, and welcome to the UUCOC. We're so happy to have all of you here this morning. For those of you who may not be familiar with our church, we are not a creedal church. We respect each individual's spiritual journey, whatever that may be, and we're here to support you in your personal journey and to learn from you and be changed by you. We're glad to have you all here this morning. Welcome.
May the light we now kindle inspire us to use our powers to heal and not to harm, to help and not to hinder, to bless and not to curse, to serve you, Spirit of love, compassion, and forgiveness. And now in Spanish. Que esta luz que ahora encendemos nos inspire a usar nuestros dones y poderes para sanar y no para herir, para ayudar y no para impedir, para bendecir y no para maldecir, para servirte a ti, espíritu de amor, compasión y perdón. Come into this circle of love and justice by Marilyn Sewell. Come into this circle of love and justice. Come into this community where we can dream and believe in those dreams. Come into this holy place where we remember who we are and how we want to be and live. Come now and let us worship together.
All right, church, rise and shine in body and or spirit as we enter, rejoice, and come in. Rejoice and come in, enter, rejoice and come in. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice and come in. Open your ears to the song. Open your ears to the song. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Open your hearts, everyone. Open your hearts, everyone. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Don't be afraid of some change. Don't be afraid of some change. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in.
Yes.
Because we love one another, we honor each individual's spiritual journey. We celebrate life's abundance in service to each other, our community, and the world. We connect with each other in love, respect, and acceptance. Thus do we covenant together.
And now in Spanish.
Porque nos amamos uno al otro. Honramos el viaje espiritual de cada individuo. Celebramos la abundancia de la vida en el servicio a entre sí, nuestra comunidad y el mundo. Ponemos en contacto a unos con otros en el amor, respeto y aceptación. Así que hacemos pacto.
You are not alone with your sorrows, as I am not alone with mine. Each Sunday, we share the burdens of our hearts with one another, for often a burden shared is a burden lightened.
Comfort me. Comfort me. Comfort me. Oh, my soul, comfort me, comfort me, comfort me, oh, my soul.
And likewise, we celebrate with one another for the joys of life.
All right, I'm going to ask you to rise and shine once again in body and or spirit. We're going to raise the roof a little bit in joy for our joys. Alleluia, 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 sing and rejoice. Alleluia, 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 sing and rejoice. Sing and rejoice, alleluia, sing and rejoice, alleluia, sing and rejoice, alleluia, sing and rejoice. I'm going to give you one more try. Alleluia, 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 sing and rejoice. Alleluia, 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 sing and rejoice. Sing and rejoice, hallelujah. Sing and rejoice, hallelujah. Sing and rejoice, hallelujah. Sing and rejoice. Thank you.
Good morning. The feminist scholar Carol Myers has said that Exodus may be the most important book of the Bible, and I think it is to me. This morning, I'd like to start by reading a piece from Exodus from the edition of the Bible that I use, the Poverty and Justice Bible. As the executive director and minister of your Texas Unitarian Universalist Justice Ministry, our state action network, I'm always wanting to find moments of scripture, of music, of the sacred that speak to our work for justice. This edition of the Bible I found out about from the Reverend Dr. William Barber, the leader of Moral Mondays in North Carolina and of the Poor People's Campaign. So, this piece has only deepened in importance to me over the years, and I invite you to connect with it in whatever way is authentic to you and your lived experience being one of the sources of our faith as Unitarian Universalists. This comes from Exodus chapter 16, verses 19 through 22. After the Israelites had walked safely through on dry ground, Miriam, the sister of Aaron, was a prophet, so she took her tambourine and led the other women out to play their tambourines and to dance. Then she sang to them. Miriam, the sister of Aaron, was a prophet, so she took her tambourine, led the other women out to play their tambourines and to dance. Then she sang to them. Now, this is the story of enslaved people on a long, hard journey from their captives through the desert to the promised land. And while each of us in our lived experience may be able to relate to this in different ways, we may come from people who enslaved others, we may come from people who were enslaved, it may be both, it may be none, it may be that we feel ourselves in the desert on a long journey toward liberation, however you connect with it. When I first heard this passage, what spoke to me as a musician, as a female minister, was this idea that we had a female prophet leading people in hard times through music and dance. And that was a hallelujah moment for me. Representation is really important in this work, in this world. And so one of my prayers for you is that you may see yourself represented in the places and the things that are so important to you. In the pandemic, it has felt like a journey through a desert, through a very difficult time, hoping that we would see greater access, greater accountability, greater collective liberation on the other side, whenever we may get to whatever another side of this time might be. One of the words in this passage that I love is so. And we know that Bibles are translated differently over time, but I love that in this Poverty and Justice version of the Bible, it says, Miriam, the sister of Aaron, was a prophet, so she took her tambourine. Not she was a prophet but she had a tambourine. Not she was a prophet. Oh, and they tolerated her tambourine. She was a prophet, so she took a tambourine. That music, that dance, that joy, that hope was part of her prophetic life. And here's the piece that has really come to my heart and soul recently. Think about it. People preparing to escape from their captors in the night, how quietly they would have had to move. And yet the women chose to bring tambourines. The care they must have taken, the commitment in this story to joy, that the hope that a tambourine would be played somewhere, sometime, and that in what must have been small packs, they couldn't have carried much on this long journey through the desert. Rather than saving every space for food or for water, the women saved space for joy, for dancing, for music, that hope. That is what it is to be a person of faith in that story, to have faith that your needs would be provided for, that there was room to bring joy. That is a lot of talking about that story, but there is so much in four lines that gives me hope in these times. Now, I want to ask you to think about something. What is the thing that you need to pack for this life to get through the things that are hard? What is your tangible sense of joy, of hope, of nourishment, that all will be provided for, the faith that collective liberation is coming? What do you have in your pack? What are you bringing with you on this life's journey? For me, it is almost quite literally a tambourine. Music, dance. I teach a dance class that's akin to Zumba for UUs all around the world and community members all around the world every Friday morning. And no matter what, I'm dancing. When the news came down about the Supreme Court's decision that basically nullified Roe v. Wade, my phone as the executive director of the Justice Ministry was blowing up 15 minutes before I had to lead folks in dance. And I had no choice in that moment. I suppose I did have a choice, but to me, there is no choice. Spiritual practice, joy, community, showing up for each other, no matter what. So 15 minutes after that devastating news, I was dancing and it was good. It got me through. My spirit was good all day. And I mean, that does not mean that it wasn't horrible news. We saw it coming and still horrible news. But we need our spiritual practices to keep showing up, to keep being part of this work, to keep being there for each other, to say to each other, the work of collective liberation, the work of justice, the work of Unitarian Universalism, of spiritual community, of the eighth principle that many of our congregations are adopting about accountability, about multicultural community building, about anti-racism and dismantling systems of oppression. That work is generations of work. Not just our lifetime of work, generations of work. I think often of the song, I Am Willing by Holly Near, who also wrote, We Are a Gentle, Angry People, that's in our hymnal. But in my band, Parker Woodland, I often sing, I Am Willing in our shows, in our community events. There is a line, it dishonors those who go before us. So lift me up to the light of change. And what it's saying is that to give up hope would dishonor the ancestors, would dishonor those people who fought for Roe v. Wade, who fought for civil rights, who have fought for marriage equality, who have fought for this earth, for all of our principles. It would dishonor them. It would dishonor all of this sacred faith tradition we have were we not to keep fighting. So I ask you, as the director of your Unitarian Universalist Justice Ministry, what spiritual resources are you packing for the journey to make sure that you have what it takes to stay in it? This is a hard time. This is a really hard time emotionally for many of us. Another one of the resources that I'm packing is community and the support and the nourishment that I get from the different groups of people that I roll with. So today, you may not be feeling it right now, because I put on my bright colors and I summoned the spirit that I want to be in this world. But I've actually had a few very hard days, and today has really been the pinnacle of it. And so before I sat down to speak with you, wishing I could be with you in person, but before I sat down to speak with you, I thought about who I wanted to hold close to me. And so I'm wearing my UU The Vote t-shirt. So one of the sources of joy and commitment in my life is knowing that I'm a part of something bigger, that we are all a part of something bigger, that UUs all around the country are working to fight racist gerrymandering and voter suppression and the threats to democracy. So I want to invite you to keep that image of dancing in the desert, of singing and playing a tambourine. And remember that at the Texas UU Justice Ministry, we are seeking to bring that joy into our work as well. And I want to invite you to be part of it. I'd be remiss if I didn't say first, I want to thank you for the ways that you've already been part of it. Thank you for your congregation's support. Thank you for the folks who have shown up as volunteers, to those of you who are sustaining givers every month. We so appreciate your support. We are working to hire a community organizer. We are working to get our digital communications and activism up to date and really working for us to organize UUs all around the state. We've learned from this time of pandemic that we don't just show up at the Capitol, though we will. In winter 2023, we will be back at the Capitol, and I really want to see you there. Please, please make the commitment to yourself today that when you hear from TXUUJM that it's time to go to the Capitol for lobby day, for legislative action day, that you're coming. We want you there. And showing up in person every couple years for the Ledge is not all we're going to do by any stretch. We know from my predecessor, Reverend Chuck Freeman, how important it is to show up in activism in your community day in, day out. We are doing that also, though, on Zoom now. So there's the things that you're doing in your frontline community, but the Justice Ministry is also gathering folks every week for what we call Action Hour over Zoom. And so that makes it accessible to all of us to build community as justice seekers around the state. We get together, we get on Zoom, and we take a few actions together that are laid out by the volunteer leaders, and they reflect our focus areas at TxUJM. And as Unitarian Universalists, they're guided by our principles. They're voted on by you. The congregation's voted on racial justice, healthcare access, climate justice, and several others. You can find a lot more at txuujm.org. Again, that's txuujm.org, and on our Facebook. So I'd like to invite you to join us in that. The organization is in a place of study leave right now and rest before we resume in August. So I would love to see you there. One of the things I'm reading on study leave is Incantations for Rest. Can you see that? By Atina O. Danner. It's poems, meditations, and other magic. And I really, really recommend it. I've also been reading We Cry Justice. This is Reading the Bible with the Poor People's Campaign. And what this book does is it gives us nuggets, again, related to poverty and justice, so that those of us who are Unitarian Universalists, but seek to be in multiracial, multi-faith, interfaith activism out in the world, which is how we're going to get it done, y'all. It's how we're going to get it done. That we connect with what is a key source for many people, scripture. And so if you're someone who grew up with the Bible and it was used against you, this may be a place to find some healing. If you're someone like me who grew up Unitarian Universalist with almost no Bible, this is a place to get some spiritual literacy and connection. So we have a group every Thursday night from 6:30 to 7 p.m. with the Poor People's Campaign on Zoom that is reading this book together little by little and discussing and deepening our commitment to the work of justice and addressing poverty in our systems. Should we breathe together? I know that's a lot. The Justice Ministry has been around for 10 years. I celebrate all of you who've been involved. I thank you for the chance to speak with your congregation. I hope I get to see you on Zoom and in person. And I hope that you will Find those tambourines in your life, that spiritual sustenance that keeps you nourished. I hope that like us, you will rest when you need to rest. Develop a rhythm of action, reflection, rest, and nourishment. Action, reflection, rest, and nourishment. When you're part of a community of justice seekers like TXUUJM, you can always trust that the work that you're doing doesn't need to be everything. It can't be everything. But if you do your part, you're part of something much bigger. We are bending the arc of Texas toward justice, and we're doing it together. With that, I would like to share with you a few words from a few other folks, and then I have a little song. Reverend Chuck Freeman, my predecessor, told me recently, stay strong, keep up the fight. He said that the way we are going to win and the things that we are working on is by being committed and organized, that the successes that have happened in other states like Arizona and Georgia did not happen overnight. Those were decades of work, and that is work we are going to do. I also asked our Texas U Justice Ministry rep, Carrie Stewart, what lessons she took away from our General Assembly. And she gave me these two to share with you. From Ibram Kendi, take back our power. And from Jason Hicks, who is from UU The Vote, organize, organize, organize. I invite you to think about how to take back our power as people of faith, as Unitarian Universalists working for justice. I invite you to organize in your congregations and your communities and to tell the Texas U Justice Ministry what you're doing so we can lift it up and amplify it. And then last but not least, the song that has been on my heart that has been like a tambourine for me is Wo Ya Ya from our hymnal. Kimberly Davis, one of my colleagues, and this is why the name Kimberly came out of my mouth a moment ago, Kimberly Davis writes about music from our hymnal. And Reverend Davis says this about Wo Ya Ya. Written by Ghanaian drummer Sol Amarifio, Wo Ya Ya is the title song of a 1971 album by Osibisa, a musical group of Ghanaian and Caribbean musicians. It was frequently heard in work camps throughout Central West Africa in the 70s and 80s. When I said yes to this call to ministry with Texas UU Justice Ministry, this song came to my heart over and over again. I would walk my dog out in Bastrop where I live, and I would just sing it to myself. I wonder if you have a song like that from our hymnal. I would love to know what it is. Here's mine. We are going, heaven knows how we are going, but we know within, and we'll get there. Heaven knows how we will get there, but we know we will. It will be hard, we know, and the road will be muddy and rough, but we'll get there. Heaven knows how we will get there, but we know we will. Wo ya ya, wo ya ya, wo ya ya, wo ya ya. We are going, heaven knows where we are going, but we know within, and we'll get there. Heaven knows how we will get there, but we know we will. It will be hard, we know, and the road will be muddy and rough, but we'll get there. Heaven knows how we will get there, but we know we will. Wo ya ya, wo ya ya, Wo ya ya. May we get there together. May we sing and dance along the way. May we be in this justice-seeking, shared liberation work for our lifetime and many to come. Blessed be.
Okay, once again, if you will, rise in body and or spirit as we sing.
Where the oil of gladness dissolves all mourning. Oh, we'll build a promised land that will be. Come, build a land where sisters and brothers, anointed by God, may then create peace, where justice shall roll down like waters, and peace like an ever-flowing stream. We'll build a land where we bring the good tidings to all the afflicted and all those who mourn, and we'll give them garlands instead of ashes. Oh, we'll build a land where peace is born. Come, build a land for sisters and brothers, anointed by God, may then create peace, where justice shall roll down like water, and peace like an ever-flowing stream. We'll build a land, building up ancient cities, raising up devastations from old, restoring ruins of generations. Oh, we'll build a land of people so bold. Come, build a land where sisters and brothers, anointed by God, shall then create peace, where justice shall roll down like waters, and peace like an ever-flowing stream. Come, build a land where the mantles of praises resound from spirits once faint and once weak, where like oars of righteousness stand her people. Oh, come build a land, my people we seek. Come build a land where sisters and brothers, anointed by God, may then create peace, where justice shall roll down like waters, and peace like an ever-flowing stream.
Thank you. You may be seated as you please.
We, the Unitarian Universalist Church of Oak Cliff, commit ourselves to the study and dismantling of racism and oppression within our congregation. We commit our congregation and ourselves to the work of anti-racism and anti-oppression. We commit ourselves to listening, to learning, and to action. When we fail, we commit ourselves to trying again and again. We covenant to begin this work and to continue until all of us can truly say that we are a beloved community of justice, equity, and compassion.
Good morning. This morning, we're going to continue to dig a little bit deeper into our Widening the Circle of Concern covenant. Again, it's important that we have everyone from our youngest members all the way up to our wisest members really understand why this is so important to us as a congregation and so important to our faith. This week, we're going to dig a little into the part of our covenant that says, when we fail, we commit ourselves to trying again and again. And this might be something that some of our wiser members who haven't tried to learn something new might want a little extra practice with, where our youngest members who are always trying new things might have a little bit more practice with that. So this morning, I'm going to tell a story, and this is the story of Moral the Moose. And Moral the Moose makes mistakes. When Moral was a little moose, Moral's dad took them to nursery school. Moral's dad wanted Moral to make friends. On their first day at school, at nursery school, Moral was playing with a lily pad when a little loon paddled over to Moral. "Will you share the lily pad with me so we can play a game?" asked the little loon. Moral was having fun playing games with the lily pad all by themselves, and they didn't really want to share. Moral wanted the loon to go away so that Moral could keep playing by themselves. So Moral stood up on their hind legs and then slammed back down in the water, making a big splash that splashed all over the little loon. And the little loon got scared and paddled away crying. Moral didn't make any new friends that day. At home that night, Moral told their dad that they couldn't make any friends and they didn't want to go back to nursery school the next day. "What did you do at nursery school today if you didn't find any new friends to play with?" asked Moral's dad. "Well, I played with a lily pad by myself and a little loon asked me to share so we could play together, but I didn't want to share, so I made a big splash in the pond and scared her away." "Oh," said Moral's dad, "it sounds like you made some mistakes today. That could be why you didn't make any new friends. But many, many moose make mistakes when they are learning something new." "What mistakes did I make?" asked Moral. "Well, sharing is a good way to make friends, and you can have a lot of fun playing games with friends when you share." "Oh," said Moral sadly. "So if I shared the lily pad, I might have made a new friend?" "Maybe," said Moral's dad. "And if you go back to school tomorrow, you can try again." "What other mistakes did I make?" "Well, no matter how mad you get, it's never okay to hit or push or hurt others. We have to use our words to say, no, thank you, or not right now." "Oh, so if I used my words to ask for alone time, I might have made a new friend today?" "Maybe," said Moral's dad. "And if you go back to school tomorrow, you can try again." "Did I make any other mistakes?" "Yes," said Moral's dad. "When we do hurt someone, when we hurt them either on purpose or on accident, with our body or our words or our actions, it's very important to say sorry and to try very hard not to do it again." "And if I go to school tomorrow and say sorry to the little loon, might I make a new friend?" "Maybe," said Moral's dad, "but you will probably have to practice sharing
and using your words and saying sorry when you hurt someone on accident before others will feel safe being your friend. Well, the next day, Moral practiced sharing and using their words. And when they spilled their paint on accident, they said sorry and helped to clean up the mess. When they got home, Moral's dad asked, "Did you make any new friends at school today?" "Not yet," said Moral. "But I practiced sharing and using my words and saying sorry when I made a mistake." "Good job. Keep practicing and you can try again tomorrow." So Moral kept going to school and kept sharing and kept using their words and kept saying sorry when they made a mistake, even on accident, until one day they made a new friend. Thank you so much, and I hope you have a beautiful morning.
Let there be an offering this morning to sustain this church, which is so special and to so many of us. We have all sorts of options also for both those of you here and those online. You may text a donation to 214-225-5996. Or you can go to www.oakcliffuu.org/donate.
From you I receive, to you I give, together we share, and from this we live. From you I receive, to you I give, together we share, and from this we live. De ti yo recibo, a ti te doy, así compartimos y vivimos hoy. De ti yo recibo, a ti te doy, así compartimos y vivimos hoy.
After, by Max A. Kutz. After the words, a quiet. After the songs, a silence. After the crowd, only the memory recalls the gathering. Peace and justice have need of you after the words, the music, and the gathering. God grant you the depth for dedication to justice. God grant you the will to be an apostle of peace. Namaste.
We extinguish this flame, but not the light of truth, the warmth of community, or the fire of commitment. These we carry in our hearts until we are together again. Extinguimos esta llama, pero no la luz de la verdad, el calor de comunidad, o el fuego de nuestro compromiso. Estos los llevamos en el corazón, hasta que estemos juntos otra vez.
And once again, church, rise in body and or spirit. And if you feel so inclined, take the hand of the person next to you as we sing.
someday we shall live in peace. We shall live in peace. We shall.